Hi, this presentation is going to discuss the chi-square goodness of fit, and we'll begin by discussing the multinomial experiment, which is somewhat familiar, as you recall our discussion of the binomial experiment, which had two possible outcomes. Well, with multinomial we have more than two, and this example here is an illustration of that. Talking about toppings on a pizza, there are several different options there, not just two. So we also recall our discussion of frequency tables and classes, and this is what we've got here. So what we're doing with the chi-square goodness of fit test is examining whether or not a frequency distribution fits an expected distribution, and we calculate a test statistic for that, and we compare the observed to the expected frequencies. So the observed frequency is O of a category is the frequency for the category observed in the sample data, and the expected is the calculated frequency. So the expected frequency is obtained assuming a specified or hypothesized distribution. So our hypothesis testing will determine that, what that is. So the expected frequency for the ith category is going to be E sub I equals NP sub I, where N is the number of trials, which is our sample size, and PI is the assumed probability of the ith category. So here's an example. We've got 200 teenagers randomly selected and asked what their favorite pizza topping is, and the results are shown down here. So we're going to find the observed frequencies and the expected frequencies. So we've got the distribution here and the frequency tables. And in this table, we've got both the observed frequency taken from here and the calculated frequency multiplying the proportion by the sample size. So if we're going to do the chi-square goodness of fit test, we need to meet a couple of criteria. First, the observed frequencies must be obtained using a random sample. And we also need a minimum of 5 cases in each frequency class. If we don't meet those, then it's not an appropriate test. If the conditions are met, then the sampling distribution for the goodness of fit test is approximated by a chi-square distribution, and we've got k minus 1 degrees of freedom. So the chi-square distribution, as you'll recall, like the t-distribution, is really a family of curves adjusted by sample size, in this case, or categories, the number of categories. So the test statistic for the chi-square goodness of fit test is here. Chi-square is the sum of, in the numerator, the observed minus expected squared divided by the expected. And so it's always a right-tailed test, as we see, where O represents the observed and E is the expected frequency for each category. And here are our steps. We first begin by stating the claim mathematically, identifying the level of significance, the alpha level, identifying the degrees of freedom, k minus 1, where k is category. Number of categories. We determine the critical value using our chi-square table, and then from that we can determine our rejection region. We then calculate our test statistic using our formula, and then we make a decision based on where that test statistic falls relative to our cutoff values, whether or not it's in the rejection region or not. So we can either reject the null or fail to reject the null. And then we go back to our initial claim and we interpret the decision in that context. So here's an example. We have a researcher who claims that the distribution of favorite toppings of pizza for teenagers is as shown below. We have 200 randomly selected teenagers surveyed. So using an alpha at the 0.01 level and the observed and expected values previously calculated, we're going to test the claim using a chi-square goodness of fit test. So our null hypothesis is that the distribution of pizza toppings is, as we saw in the previous table, we're not going to read all of that off, and the alternative is that the distribution differs. So we have HO equal to the expected and HA not equal to the expected. Because there are 5 categories, the K minus 1 will give us 4 degrees of freedom, and with 4 degrees of freedom at the 0.01 alpha level, our critical value for chi-square, we can see from our table, is 13.277. Next, we use our formula to calculate our test statistic, and here's our formula, the sum of the deviation from the observed and the expected squared over the expected, and if we plug in those values, we get 2 2.025. And 2.025 is not in the rejection region. We failed to reject the null hypothesis. So there's not enough evidence at the 1% level to reject the surveyor's claim, which means they could be right.